Hello and welcome to Getting Started with Sophistic Reinforcement. In this series of videos, you will get to know the basic workflows and tools of Revit and Sophistic RC. The Getting Started is aimed at anyone who already has basic knowledge of creating positioning and form worksheets in Revit. You're welcome to click along directly during the video. The sample project is available for download for this purpose. Here on the right, in the project browser, we can see four reinforcement sheets, including views that have already been prepared. We'll start in the first view and reinforce a column. In the Structure tab, we select the rebar tool. Here on the left in the type selection, we set the bar diameter to 8 millimeters. In the newly opened rebar shape browser, here on the right, we can choose a rebar shape. We can choose stirrup. As soon as we move the cursor over a component, we are already shown a preview of the rebar. By the way, in the reinforcement mode, extended tooltips can be switched on and off next to the mouse for modeling. With the help of the spacebar, the stirrup can be rotated to different corners and the rebar is placed with a mouse click. We can end the command with escape. The stirrup automatically aligns to the concrete cover of the host. The cover can be adjusted here in the instance properties. That way, the constraints between the rebar and the column update with changes. The stirrup also adapts to later changes in the concrete cover or the column cross section. So let's undo, and in the view below, we will also find the rebar. We don't want to have a single rebar, but an entire rebar set. To achieve that, we simply change the layout rule in the properties to maximum spacing and set a spacing of 150 millimeters. In order to get multiple spacing rules along the column, we need multiple rebar sets. For that, we will use the split tool of Sophistic Reinforcement. Now we select the rebar set exactly where we want to split it. Then we can adjust the spacing of the lower rebar set to 100 millimeters. The length of the rebar set can also be adjusted later at any time using these shape handles. We can switch back to the first view and add the longitudinal bars. We select the rebar tool again, and this time we choose a diameter of 12 millimeters. In the rebar shape browser, we select the straight rebar. If we hover with the cursor over the column, we see that the rebar is misaligned. We therefore change the orientation to parallel to cover, the layout rule to fixed number, and the set to quantity of 2. Now the rebars are placed along the column. Click with the mouse to place the rebars and end the command with escape. These rebars also align to the concrete cover. With the help of shape handles, we can slide the rebars to the right position. Now, let's go back to the column view and check the length of the rebars. We can change the length of the rebar in this view, also with shape handles, and then mirror them with the mirror command along the axis of the column. We can now change to the 3D view, where we can see and check our created reinforcements. In order to see them more clearly, we can use the unobstructed command of Sophistic Reinforcement. With this, we are already done reinforcing the first column, and we can simply copy it to the second one via propagate. So now we see that this column is shorter, so we have to adjust the length of the rebar sets. It's an easy task to change the length in the side view, where we first change the stirrups using the shape handles, and then the longitudinal rebars. By the way, we can use Sophistic's match tool to easily adjust other longitudinal rebars to the same length.